Morning students, today's class we will see about gestational trophoblastic neoplasia. Gestational trophoblastic neoplasia is the spectrum of proliferative abnormalities of trophoblasts associated with pregnancy. Gestational trophoblastic disease, otherwise known as small r pregnancy, comprises of a set of interrelated conditions originating from anomalous development of the placenta. It is characterized by the conversion of chorionic villi into mass of clear vesicles. There may be no fetus or degenerating fetus may be present. The diagnosis may include complete and partial hereditiform moles, invasive moles, gestational choriocarcinomas, and placental-side trophoblastic tumors. The rate of occurrence is 1:15,000 pregnancies. Molar pregnancies are usually diagnosed during the first trimester of pregnancy. Hereditiform mole, otherwise known as molar pregnancy or vesicular mole, is an abnormal condition of the placenta where there are partially degenerative and partially proliferative changes in the young chorionic villi. Types: it is commonly classified into complete and incomplete. Complete is characterized by gross hydropic swelling of the placental villi with usually marked hyperplasia of both chorionic layers. The alterations in the chorionic villi early in pregnancy bring about death of and reabsorption of embryo. Ovum is converted to amorphous mass of vesicles intermingled with blood clots. Incomplete or partially hereditiform mole is an abnormal conceptus with an embryo or fetus that tends to die early. The part of placenta may reveal molar changes and rest would remain as functional organ. There is no focal villus swelling and focal trophoblastic hyperplasia, usually involving the syncytia trophoblast only. The complete mold and partial mold, the main difference are: in complete mold there is no fetal tissue, partial mold some fetal tissues are there. In complete mold uterine size is small, partial mold the size is less. Complete mold complication is common, partial mold associated with less complications. Etiology: it may be because of low nutrition and socioeconomic status, low dietary intake of carotene, vitamin A deficiency, maternal age older than 13 years and in the teenage pregnancy, use of oral contraceptives, history of irregular menstruations, history of prior vesicular mole, cytogenic abnormality, disturbed maternal immune mechanism in case of rise of gamma globulin level in the absence of hepatic disease, an increased association with AB blood group which possesses no ABO antibody. Pathology: principally it is a disease of chorion. Death of ovum is a must. Secretion from hyperplastic cells and transferred substance from the maternal blood accumulate in the stroma of the villi, results in distension of the villi to small vesicles. This fluid is similar to ascitic fluid but rich in HCG. Naked eye appearance is mass filled with uterus made of multiple chains and clusters of cysts of varying size, not trace of embryo or amniotic fluid. Microscopic appearance, absence of blood vessels, thinning of stromal tissues are seen. Clinical features include the age and parity. This is common in the teenage and elderly patients with high parity. Symptoms include vaginal bleeding is common, varying degree of lower abdominal pain due to overdistension of uterus, concealed hemorrhage, rarely perforation of uterus, infection, uterine contraction. And constitutional symptoms include become sick without any reason, vomiting become more exaggerated, breathlessness due to pulmonary embolization, expulsion of grape-like vesicles per vagina, history of quickening absent. And signs include features of early months of pregnancy, patients look more ill, pallor, features of preeclampsia, perabdominal, the size of uterus is more than gestational age, feel of uterus firm and elastic due to absence of amniotic fluid, fetal parts are not felt, not any fetal movement, absence of fetal heart rate. The classical clinical features of complete mole include abnormal vaginal bleeding, lower abdominal pain, hypermenses gravidarum, features of early onset of preeclampsia, uterus is more than dates, absence of fetal parts and a fetal heart sound, expulsion of vesicle tissue, thecal lutein cyst of ovaries, hyperthyroidism, serum HCG more than 1 lakh unit, USG snowstorm appearance. Vaginal examination shows finding of vesicles, unilateral bilateral enlargement of ovary may be palpable. The investigations include full blood count, ABO and RH grouping, hepatic and renal thyroid function tests are carried out, sonography which shows characteristic feature of the molar pregnancy, snowstorm appearance, quantitative estimation of chorionic gonadotropin, high HCG titer in the urine, plain X-ray abdomen if the uterine size is more than 16 weeks, and negative fetal shadow may be helpful. Straight X-ray of the chest should be also carried out. The routine evidence of pulmonary embolization even in the benign mold. CT and MRI, routine use of computed tomography or magnetic resonance image for diagnosis that is not recommended. Definitive diagnosis is made by histological examination of the products of conception. Differential diagnosis includes threatened abortion, fibroid or ovarian tumor, multiple pregnancy. The complications, immediate complications, the first is hemorrhage and shock. The cause of hemorrhages are separation of vesicles from its attachment to decidua. The hemorrhage may be concealed or revealed. Massive intraperitoneal hemorrhage, which may be first feature of a perforating mold during evacuation of the mold due to atonic uterus or uterine injury. The second immediate complication is sepsis. Increased risk of sepsis due to, as there is no protective membrane, the vaginal organisms can creep into the uterine cavity. Presence of degenerated vesicles, slugging decidua, and old blood favors nidation of bacterial growth. Increased operative interference. And next complication is perforation of uterus. The uterus may be injured due to perforating mold, which may produce massive intraperitoneal hemorrhage during vaginal evacuation, especially by conventional D&D method or during curettage following suction evacuation. Preeclampsia with convulsion on rare occasion. Acute pulmonary insufficiency due to pulmonary embolization of trophoblastic cells with or without villi stroma. Symptoms usually begins within 4 to 6 hours following evacuation. Coagulation failure due to pulmonary embolization of trophoblastic cells, as they cause fibrin and platelets deposition within the muscular artery. Risk factors for malignant change include the late complications are choriocarcinoma. The risk factors for malignant change include age above 40, irrespective of parity, having 3 previous births irrespective of the age, initial serum HCG is 1 lakh, uterine size is more than 20 weeks, previous history of molar pregnancy, large, that is the lutein cyst. This choriocarcinoma, it is a malignant neoplasm of the cyst, cytotrophoblast and syncytia trophoblastic elements with absent villus formation. It is also called chorioepithelioma. It may either follow molar pregnancy, early pregnancy loss due to miscarriage or ectopic pregnancy, or even in a normal pregnancy. It is suspected when these patients develop irregular vaginal bleeding in the absence of any retained bits of pregnancy products. Prognosis. Immediate risk of hemorrhage and sepsis are markedly diminished due to early diagnosis, blood transfusion and treatment. About 15-20% of complete molds progress persistent gestational trophoblastic disease where there is a plateau revelation of re-elevation of HCG level. It's about 5% cases metastatic disease develop. The risk of recurrence of hyaldimo mold in future pregnancy is about 1-4%. However, the chance of fetal malformation is not increased following chemotherapy. The improvement and long-term prognosis may attribute to the following factors like recognition of high-risk factors related to choriocarcinoma, careful follow-ups of serum beta HCG, use of cytotoxic drug at optimum time and in the right case. The management. The principles of management include supportive therapy to restore blood loss and prevent infection, to evacuate uterus for regular follow-up. It's divided into two groups. The group A, mold in the process of expulsion. Group B, uterus is inert or inactive. Supportive therapy for group A. The patient should be present in the variable degree of bleeding. Start ringer lactate. Arrangements of blood transfusion should be done. Group B, blood should be kept ready before the elective evacuation of the uterus. Definitely therapy for group A is suction evacuation is the best. It can be done under diazepam sedation or under general anesthesia. After evacuation is completed, methadone 0.2 mg given intramuscularly. Group B, vaginal evacuation as soon as the diagnosis is made. If the cervix is favorable, suction evacuation by oxytocin 20 units in 500 ml. Cervical dilatation followed by evacuation done and condition of the patient should be monitored closely. So if the cervix is unfavorable, slow dilatation of cervix by laminaria 10 followed by suction evacuation of misoprostol 400 microgram 3 hours before surgery is equally effective. Complications of vaginal evacuations include injury to the uterus, hemorrhage and shock, acute pulmonary insufficiency due to pulmonary embolization of trophoblastic cells, thyroid storm in the presence of hyperthyroid state. Hysterectomy is rarely done. The indications for hysterectomy include profuse vaginal bleeding, cervix is unfavorable for immediate evacuation, and hysterectomy's indications include patients over 35 years of age, patients completed family irrespective of the age. Prophylactic chemotherapy. Drugs are toxic and cause death, so it is not appropriate to treat all patients with a routine prophylactically. The conditions in which they use are: the HCG level fails to become normal in the stipulated time, that is 4 to 6 weeks, or there is a re-elevation within the 4 weeks, evidence of metastasis irrespective of the level of HCG, where the malignant sequelae is higher, judged by the risk factors, and where the follow-up facilities are not available. A regimen: injection methotrexate 1 mg per kg IM, alternative days for 7 days. Injection folinic acid 6 mg IM on the alternative days are given. Regimes will be repeated every 15 days after viewing the HCG result. Follow-up. Routine follow-up is mandatory for all cases at least for 6 months. Prime objective is to detect choriocarcinoma. The intervals of follow-up. The follow-up should be at the interval of 1 week till serum HCG become negative. It is usually takes 4 to 6 weeks. Once negative, she should be followed up every 1 month for interval of 6 months. Woman undergone chemotherapy should be followed up for 1 year after the HCG has been normal. Follow-up protocol include history and physical examination, HCG assay in serum and urine, contraceptive advice for these patients. If the patient decides she can become pregnant after 6 months of negative HCG assay, but following chemotherapy, she should not conceive for 1 year after the completion of treatment. IUCD is contraindicated because frequent association with irregular bleeding, that is the feature coexists with choriocarcinoma, so sometimes it may go unnoticed. Combined oral pills can be used after HCG value become normal. Battery method also can be used. Surgical sterilization if she completed the family. Unfavorable manifestation include persistent ill health, irregular vaginal bleeding or continuing amenorrhea, appearance of respiratory symptoms, subinvolution, appearance of secondary metastasis in vagina. The chest X-ray shows positive findings of canine bird shadow. HCG titer remain elevated. The nursing assessment include monitor the vital signs, not symptoms of early onset of preeclampsia. Assess the amount and type of vaginal bleeding. Not the presence of any other vaginal discharge. Assess for urine protein, palpate urine, uterine height. If above the umbilicus, measure the fundal height. Determine the date of last menstrual period and date of positive pregnancy test. Evaluate CPC result and RH time. So, in short, gestational neoplasia is the hereditary form of molar pregnancy, a disease of the placenta, where there is partially degenerative and partially neoplastic proliferation of the chorionic villi. The patients commonly present the abnormal vaginal bleeding, pain abdomen, and sometimes expulsion of grape-like vesicles tissues per vagina. Confirmation of the diagnosis made by ultrasonography showing snowstorm, appearance of the uterus, and abnormally raised levels of serum HCG is the characteristic. History supports the diagnostic. Complications of molar pregnancy are hemorrhage, preeclampsia, sepsis, uterine perforation, and coagulation failure. Risk of developing choriocarcinoma is about 2 to 10%. Management is by suction evacuation is the method of treatment. Patient may need blood transfusion. Follow-up of the patient is mandatory. It is done by frequent estimation of serum HCG till the HCG become tighter. The woman should be avoid pregnancy for 1 year after following the treatment of molar pregnancy with methotrexate. Thank you. Thank you for listening.